Welcome back, and you're here with the Fuller Fanatic. On today's overview, I'll be taking a look at a very popular model by Olamic Cutlery in California. It's the Busker Front Flipper, which is a sub 6-inch mini size build. For those who are unfamiliar with Olamic, they are known for their vast array of finishes and combination of materials used, all done in-house per the client's request. As for the Busker, which boasts 10 different deployment options, I must admit, this has to be the ultimate fidget-packed front flipper in this size. While the means of deployment plays a huge role, I believe, in my opinion, the detent and its tension plays a larger part. The detent ball is a white and black marbled ceramic, and its tune is set applying minimal resistance on the blade's face. And this just being my thoughts after some time with the Busker. The detent ramp is an important and big factor, and this ramp is very, very steep. And in addition, it's carved to the exact shape of the detent ball. Usually, the ramp is a V-shape from what I've previously seen, but this shape makes the disengagement so smooth and satisfying in terms of getting the detent back up onto the blade face. Honestly, you can barely feel it, if at all. The handle measures 3 3/375 of an inch and is made from a high-grade titanium. This handle is the Rock's Tie style that has a bit of a chisel look to it, which has been acid washed to add texture to the body lines. The handle is very slim, and its thickness comes in at 0.40 inch. The Busker is a frame locking flipper that is running a steel lock bar insert with an over travel stop. On the show side, there are 5 milled holes where you can actually see the blade's edge while in a closed position. And there is a traditional style lanyard hole at the rear of the handle. This Busker is sporting a bronze pivot and body screws that have all been polished. The pocket clip is a Todd Begg style ceramic insert mounted via 2 standoffs that are then mounted into the frame. Following suit with the frame and clip, the backspacer sports the same rock pattern. This solid chunk of titanium has been milled, polished, then anodized to this 14K golden color. And as you can see, Olamic took it the extra mile, making this a floating backspacer. And another little Olamic signature is the unit serial number being displayed on the spacer's underside. Other than the ceramic detent and clip insert, the lock bar insert and stop pin, the handle and hardware are all titanium. The tab on the Busker sits proud of the frame just enough, and the jimping is wide and smooth, coupled with a slight upward angle, makes for a very easy deployment. The Busker has 4 different blade shapes to choose from. This is the Semper blade shape, which seems to be a bit more pocket friendly than others. Coming in at 2 3/375 of an inch in length and a blade thickness of 138 of an inch, the Busker utilizes M390 steel and sports a flat ground sheep's foot blade. As another means of deploy, the blade has a forward canted thumb hole that can be reverse flicked as well as flicked with the thumb. And even the slow roll method can be pulled off. This blade has a light acid wash finish, and due to its surface being more grippy than a satin or a mirror finish, I can easily reverse flick the blade without using the hole, adding to the insane fidget factor. The only billboarding on the Busker is the company name and logo, model name on the show side, with only the steel type on the lock side. The Busker has an overall length of 5 8/375 of an inch and weighs only 2.9 ounces. Another claim to fame for the Busker is even though it's a sub 6-inch flipper, someone with larger hands can still fit all fingers comfortably onto the frame and the hammer grip without issues, which I find to be very true. The subtle upwards curve, along with the non-aggressive jimping, makes for a pleasant deploy with the thumb stud. And even with the side of my index finger, where on most front flippers, the index method starts to irritate the hand, there's no issues here. The action is insane, especially on the blade's retraction. To see a blade this small glide along the bearings like a 3.5-inch blade is kinda crazy. And the fact this build is 5 or 6 years old and still holds its fidget crown speaks to this design and Olamic's quality. Included with the Busker is a cert of authenticity. Starting with the model, blade length, shape, steel and finish, handle and clip type, and their materials used, serial number and birth date. And that's in the back of the Olamic case the build comes in. This Busker is currently online for $545, and I've even seen some dress models for upwards of $800. So the Busker is not cheap by any means. And at about $100 per inch, the question is it worth it? And heavy is the head, so they say. And I guess it costs to be king. I will say it is definitely a one-of-a-kind experience. And I don't want to leave out the fact, at its small size, this still is the loudest knife I own, hands down, and really clicky in a good way. The disengagement and the detent falling back into the hole both emit a unique ticking or clicking sound. So for all those fidgeters out there who love that audible to go with the fidgeting, this build will be high on the list. And to answer the main question, is it worth it? This isn't a loaner or one for review to be sent back. This is definitely mine and here to stay. And if you own a Busker, please comment down below with your own personal thoughts on the build and action. Is it your go-to flipper when you're in the fidget mode? And if not, what do you believe outperforms the Busker? Hit the like button if you enjoyed the content and share the link with others. Subscribe to the channel for upcoming vids. And with that, I'm signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.